So hello everyone, and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Iska link you will find in the description, and here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also ask any doubt. You can also follow me here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding Atmanirbhar Hastshilpkar scheme. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Atmanirbhar Hastshilpkar scheme launched with an objective of providing financial assistance to the artisans? Hastshilpkar means artisans. Okay, so Atmanirbhar self-reliant, Hastshilpkar artisans. Theek hai. So you have to identify incorrect statement with respect to this scheme. So remember guys, this scheme has been launched by Northeastern Development Finance Corporation Limited, which in short is NEDFI, Northeastern Development Finance Corporation Limited. Okay, and the objective of this scheme is to provide financial assistance to artisans. Ye question mein mention tha, for income generating activities, for setting up of, for expansion of, for modernization of, for working capital requirement. ठीक है, ऑफ देयर बिजनेस. ठीक है, एंड दिट्स इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन दिस ईयर 2021. अभी दो चार दिन पहले ही लॉन्च हुआ है. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द मिनिस्ट्री इज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. ठीक है, विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर जी किशन रेड्डी इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ डेवलपमेंट फॉर नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट टाइप ऑफ फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस इज प्रोवाइडेड. द फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस विल बी प्रोवाइडेड गाइज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कोलैटरल फ्री लोन्स that would be repayable in during the period of 24 months. 24 महीने के अंदर अंदर उनको वापस करना पड़ेगा. ठीक है, now you must be wondering कि loan provide करा रहे हैं तो what type of financial assistance is this? So financial assistance में यहाँ पे interest subsidy मिलेगी. They will get, the artisans will get subsidized interest rate of 6% per annum. The loans will be provided at a subsidized interest rate of 6% per annum. And if an artisan regularly pays his principal, his interest, then 1% additional incentive will also be provided. Okay, and during the launch ceremony, remember 17 artisans have been provided rupees 1 lakh per artisan. 17 artisan ko 1 lakh rupees per head diya gaya tha during the launch ceremony. Okay, so this was about this scheme, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify incorrect statement. It has been launched by Northeastern Development Finance Corporation Limited, NEDFI. It is absolutely correct. The financial assistance will be provided in terms of collateral free loans. Yes, this is also correct. The loan is repayable in 24 months. Ye bhi theek hai. Subsidized interest rate is 5% per annum. That is not 5% per annum, that's 6% per annum. Theek hai, wo kitna tha? 6% per annum. So therefore the correct answer will be what, option D, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. Okay, and guys, in yesterday's session ek confusion ho gayi thi. G20 presidency, G20 presidency 2021 is Italy, 2022 it will be Indonesia, and 2023 it will be India. ठीक है, so this is the correct one. Please इसको याद रखना. 2021 इटली था, 2022 इंडोनेशिया होगा, एंड 2023 इंडिया होगा. ठीक है, मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. Consider the following statements with respect to We Think Digital program, and you have to identify the correct statement. Remember, this We Think Digital program is being implemented by National Commission for Women since 2018. ठीक है, तो उसके under, उसी के वो news में था, and that's why we are discussing about this We Think Digital program. So why was it in news? Because National Commission for Women headed by Rekha Sharma has launched an online resource center. An online resource center has been launched under the We Think Digital program. And what is this online resource center, by the way? So remember, it will help women in distress on issues related to online safety things, and also related to cyber frauds. Theek hai? And the center, this resource center will provide information, will provide cyber security related information in the form of posters, awareness videos, quiz, and self-learning modules. Theek hai? Moving ahead, talking about this We Think Digital program. So as I told you, this was launched in the year 2018 with the objective to help women to raise their awareness level on the digital front and to help them fight against the cyber frauds. Cyber frauds se fight karne ke liye unko awareness provide karana. This is the basic objective of this scheme. And remember, it is being implemented by National Commission for Women in collaboration with Facebook and Cyber Peace Foundation. And till now, total 1,75,000 women have been benefited under the scheme. And during its ongoing third phase, matlab abhi iska kya kaun sa phase chal raha hai? Third phase. During its ongoing third phase, the target has been set to provide benefit to 1.5 lakh women. 1.5 lakh mahilaon ko iska fayda diya jayega under the third phase of this particular program. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question then. It is being implemented by NCW in collaboration with Google and Cyber Peace Foundation. Google nahi hai, kaun hai? Facebook hai. Theek hai? Statement number 2, it was launched in 2018, absolutely correct. And 1,75,000 women have been benefited under the project. This is also correct. And in the third phase, which is the ongoing phase, the target is to provide benefit to 1.5 lakh women. So second and third are absolutely correct, which means option B will be the correct answer. So I hope guys this question is clear. Now moving ahead to question number 3. Which of the following foundations in collaboration with Niti Aayog has launched a national research symposium, which is Convoke 2021-22. Now what is this Convoke 2021-22? Let's talk about this. So it is basically a national research symposium, and it has been launched by Niti Aayog in collaboration with Bharti Foundation. Okay, it is a national research symposium. Now what is the objective? Ye karega kya? National Research Symposium Convoke 2021-22 ye kya hai? So remember, it is aimed at addressing challenges in imparting education and also strengthening the quality of education with special focus on all the teachers, on all the school heads and all the principals of the government schools, and also the teachers associated with the Bharti Foundation. Okay, basically education ka jo level hai, education ko impart kaise karaya jayega, uska level badhane ke liye, usko strengthen karne ke liye, this National Research Symposium Convoke 2021-22 has been launched by Niti Aayog in collaboration with Bharti Foundation. Okay, so therefore, the correct answer will be what? Bharti Foundation. Option C is ka sahi jawab hoga, because Niti Aayog ne Bharti Foundation ke saath isko launch kiya hai. Moving ahead, question number 4 pe a jao. Match the following technology innovation platform of Ministry of Heavy Industries with their focus areas. Who is the Minister of Heavy Industry, by the way? Mahendranath Pandey is the Minister of Heavy Industry, and you have to match these technology innovation platforms with their focus areas. And remember, total 6 technology innovation platforms were launched by this ministry in the month of July. In this year only. July 2021 mein ye 6 platform launch kiye the. These are the technology innovation platform of Ministry of Heavy Industries. So let's talk about these platforms. So this is a table in which you will find the name of platform, the setup and maintained by which organization, and the focus areas. Number 1 is TechnoViews. It is set up and maintained by Automotive Research Association of India, and it is focused on automotive sector. Number 2, Sanrachna. Set up and maintained by BHEL, power and renewable energy sector is the focus area. Drishti, Central Manufacturing Technology Institute, technologies associated with capital goods is the focus area. Aspire, International Center for Automotive Technology, the focus area is automotive technology development. KITE, Advanced Manufacturing Technology Development Center of IIT Madras, the focus area is robotics and virtual reality. And Surge, which is HMT MTL Limited of IISc Bangalore, and the focus area guys is machine tool. So you have to remember the setup and maintained by your organization, and you also have to remember the focus areas. Okay? So here you have to match these technology innovation platform with their focus areas. So Sanrachna is power and renewable energy. A, 2 ho gaya. Surge is machine tools. B is 3. TechnoViews, it is automotive sector. C ka ho gaya 1, एंड काइट इज रोबोटिक्स एंड वर्चुअल रियलिटी, डी का हो गया 5. एंड दृष्टि इज टेक्नोलॉजी एसोसिएटेड विद कैपिटल गुड्स, मतलब ई का हो गया 4. नाउ दिस इज द करेक्ट मैच. लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई. ए टू बी थ्री ए गए, ये भी चला गया, ये भी कैंसिल. ए टू बी थ्री, ठीक है. सी इज 1, सी इज 1. डी 5 एंड ई 4. सो ऑप्शन ई, ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑल राइट, ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 देन. With which of the following institutes, Ministry of Defence, headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh, has signed an MOU to facilitate training of teachers, to facilitate training to teachers of Sainik schools. So you must have remember this, total 100 Sainik schools अभी बनेंगे, ठीक है. Actually Sainik schools नहीं होंगे, ये Sainik schools जैसी इसके अंदर curriculum होगा, Sainik school जैसी training provide होगी, ठीक है. So 100 Sainik schools अभी in future आने वाले हैं as announced by the Ministry of Defence. But this MOU is something different. The question is, with which of the following institutes MOD has signed an MOU to provide training to the teachers of Sainik school. Remember, this institute guys is Indian Institute of Teacher Education, which is in Gandhinagar, and the objective is already mentioned in the question, to facilitate training to teachers of training school. Remember, this MOU has been signed for a period of 5 years, for a period of 5 years. And the training will be provided under two courses which are named as Guru Diksha and Pratibaddhata. Guru Diksha and Pratibaddhata are the two courses through which the trainings will be provided to the teachers of Sainik schools. Okay? So, isme itna hi padhna hai. Now let's come back to the question. The correct answer will be what? Indian Institute of Teacher Education, Gandhinagar, option B. Okay? Now let's talk about question number 6. How much percent of the capital cost of the project is provided as subsidy in general areas under the scheme for capital investment subsidy for construction, expansion, modernization of cold storages and storages for horticulture products? Now, this is a sub-scheme which is being implemented by National National Horticulture Board. Okay? And aapko ye batana hai ki kitna percent capital cost of the project is provided as subsidy in the general areas. Okay? So let's talk about this. So National Horticulture Board is implementing this scheme. Okay? And this scheme is to provide subsidy for setting up of, for expansion of and for modernization of the cold storage. Okay? It was the news and that's why we are discussing this. Actually, it was there was a reply which is submitted by the ministry with respect to this scheme. And that's why the question can be asked in your exam. Okay? So subsidy, if we talk about it, so in the general areas, 35% of the capital cost of the project is provided. While in the northeastern hilly and scheduled areas, it is 50% of the capital cost of the project. Okay? Now there is a limit also of cold storage capacity for availing this subsidy. Okay? It should be more than 5,000 metric tons and up to 10,000 metric tons. But if it is a northeastern area, then above 1,000 metric ton cold storage capacity is also eligible to get the subsidy. Okay? So therefore, the correct answer will be what? The question is regarding general areas, so 35% will be the correct answer. And now please do not get confused between the subsidies in general areas and in the northeastern hilly and scheduled areas. Okay? In general areas it is 35%, while in northeastern hilly and scheduled areas it is 50%. Now let's move ahead to question number 7. Which ministry or ministries has launched national helpline against atrocities to ensure proper implementation of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes, prevention of atrocities act of 1989. So remember, we have this act under which atrocities against scheduled castes and scheduled tribes is a punishable offense under this act. And for implementation, for proper implementation of this act, a helpline has been launched by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Okay? And it is a toll-free number, basically 14566, and the services are available in Hindi, English and regional languages of the respective states or UTs. Okay? So the correct answer will be what? Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar. Option A, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment is the correct answer. Now let's talk about question number 8. Which of the following organizations will be hosting the first of its kind Innovation Week celebrating innovation ecosystem. The heading will be this: to encourage startups in the month of January 2022. So we will discuss in detail about this when this will be launched. Currently the government has told us ki bhai dekho ye aisa hoga, and it will be hosted by DPIIT, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. Option C is the correct answer. Iske bare mein agar kuch detail aayegi, then we will discuss that. And now let's move ahead to last question for today, question number 9. This is again a one liner question. Direct aayega agar aaya to, as per the agriculture census 2015-16, and again it is also based on one of the replies given by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So as per the agricultural census 2015-16, how much percent of the total operated area in the country was operated by female operational holders? Very very important question. Women empowerment se direct relate karta hai. एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन पूछा जा सकता है. जो टोटल ऑपरेटेड एरिया था उसका कितना परसेंट वाज ऑपरेटेड बाय फीमेल ऑपरेशनल होल्डर्स एज पर द एग्रीकल्चरल सेंसस ऑफ 2015-16. ठीक है, सो इट वाज 11.72%. ऑप्शन ई, 11.72% इज द करेक्ट परसेंटेज, एंड 11.72% ऑफ द टोटल ऑपरेटेड इंडिया ऑपरेटेड एरिया इन द कंट्री वॉज ऑपरेटेड बाय द फीमेल ऑपरेशनल होल्ड. ठीक है, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन टुडे गाइज. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. आई विल सी यू टुमारो. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.